This is my review of the K9 Kannon. It's manufactured by Hyper Pet, and it is a spring-loaded bazooka, if you will, that launches an included tennis ball for your pet to chase. Dogs, I believe this is targeted for. And it's got a plunger device that is rubber band or banded, as you can see here. These bands stretch as you extend this. And then upon squeezing the trigger, pretty forceful. In practice, it doesn't really shoot the ball as far as I'd like. I didn't buy this for my dog, however. I'm a radio control enthusiast, and I lost a quadcopter. I didn't lose it. I actually ended up having it land in a tree, and I wanted to use this as a retrieval device. Basically, the way it works is you put the ball inside the end. First off, you have to draw the plunger a notch, and it's designed so you don't have to bend over and pick the ball up. You know, that's a lot of work. So basically, the ribs in the end capture the ball like this, okay? And when you pull the trigger, the ball is ejected. The problem is, for me, it didn't go as far as I needed it to. My quadcopter is pretty far up a tree, and this just doesn't do the job. So what I'm going to attempt is a modification of the end of this barrel with these ridges that are used to grasp the ball and trim those back so it doesn't grip the ball as snugly as it does. So there's a lot of drag on that, and I think that's really killing my range quite a bit. So anyway, my plan is to take my Dremel tool and grind down these ridges to let the ball pretty much float free, and hopefully that'll give me the range I need. But first, I'll give you a demo of how far it shoots in the standard configuration. We'll do the modification and go from there. So here we are outside with the K9 Kannon. Let's remove the ball from the handy holder and we'll draw out the plunger to full extension. It's a pretty difficult pull, to be honest. All the way back, we'll insert the ball in the end. Okay, and hold the gun and shoot for that tree there. See how far it makes it. You saw how far it went, about halfway actually. It rolled down to the next yard. Let's do another shot just to be sure. So about the same spot again. Draw the plunger. Insert ball. Fire. Yep. So as you can see, I've taken my Dremel tool and ground down the ridges inside here that I felt like were restraining the movement of the ball. So all four of these ridges have been ground down. So let's try a launch. Okay. So put the ball in. As you see, the ball falls in freely now. And we'll launch basically from the same place here in the yard and see what happens. Well, you know what? Not much more, if anything. In fact,
I think I may have decreased the range a little bit. So, well, even in this original form, I was disappointed with the performance of the K9 Kannon, and I can't really return it now since I've done this modification, but maybe I'll find another purpose for it. So anyway, here's been the Hyper Pet K9 Kannon review, and thanks for watching.